Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome back to Zero Time Dilemma. Previously on Zero Time, we basically cleared out the Carlos route. Now I'm showing off a bit of the United route, with some of the deadly choices that lay within. I actually recorded this a bit earlier than the rest of my playthrough, but now I'm showing it because I feel like enough of the plot has been shown where this doesn't ruin the sequence quite too badly. Let's see where this one starts. Maybe this one's earlier chronologically. First come, first saved queue.
Let us out! Let us out of here!
How long are you planning on doing that? Bang all you want, it won't open.
Damn it.
Just take a second, calm down. We need cool heads.
Hey! What the hell are you doing?
I'm sorry!
Do you know what that button does?
Well, no, but maybe the door opens with it.
You know, because of the button.
I really wasn't going to push it, though.
Kids are a pain.
But he could have a very good point. We haven't heard anything from Zero. Just sitting around here is useless.
Maybe just one tiny push?
Hey, Mira!
Just kidding. I'm not that reckless.
Don't scare me like that.
But we really don't know much at all. We may be at the point of crazy decisions. The only thing we know for sure is what time it is.
1808.
It must have been around 1330 when we fell asleep in the lounge. So,
4.5 hours?
Wow, you calculated that fast. And at your age, even.
Was it good?
I was just about to say the same thing.
Seems you still have that problem with numbers, Eric. I recall you having trouble calculating change when we first met.
Hey, come on now.
Is that how you two met? I want to hear.
Yeah? My face has got to be all red.
More of like a light pink.
I still remember every detail. The fateful encounter was on a Monday. The sky that morning in Nebraska was full of thick clouds, though the gloom cleared in an instant, like a miracle. I always mustered up my best smile for customers, even the boring regulars I was tired of seeing. I still offered the most delicious ice cream to them. I was getting sick of it, though. Oh, now, don't think it was my work I was unsatisfied with. I really truly love ice cream. But as the days passed, everything felt hollow, as if there was a hole in my heart. I had thought it was just another normal day. I wasn't expecting the moment it changed. I couldn't believe my eyes. I didn't
like
think
the icy pun I made earlier about his heart
existed in this world.
Turned out to be quite literal.
The feelings that hit me, I'd never felt anything like that before. That was when I realized this had to be a miracle. Mira entered my life. She was an angel that looked like a customer.
Shouldn't it be the other way?
The details aren't important. You look like you don't understand. Well, I don't blame you. I didn't get it either. Mira was just such a vivacious vision of beauty. I was just a lowly ice cream shop employee. Next to that, there was no way I would be a good match. But then Mira...
Cut it out. Me an angel? You gotta be kidding.
But it's true. You really are an angel to me, Mira.
One day you'll understand love too, kid. Once you get that mask off. It's full of awkward laughs and awkward animations and stares.
It's like you're a completely different person now, Eric.
Huh?
Well, earlier you were being... Your face was pretty scary.
Did I frighten you that much?
Yeah.
Oh. Gosh. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. you were probably just rattled about what's happened to us. I could tell you were a nice person under all that.
What are you? You're an odd duck.
More of an odd spear.
Looks like you've gone back to your dopey expression again. I guess you calmed down, huh?
Dopey? Man, you're really harsh, Mira. But yeah, I'm okay now. That's right, I'm fine. I can definitely smile no matter what.
Then tragedy happens, and he never smiles again.
I wonder why Zero decided to lock us up in here anyway.
Right. Seems like too much effort for it to be just a joke.
A lot of money was pumped into this whole thing.
Maybe all of this is supposed to be part of the GCOM experiment? They wanted to investigate how a closed space affected change on emotions, right?
But then why did they want normal people like us to apply? Wouldn't you want people in helpful professions to go to Mars? Like military officials, researchers, other skilled professionals like that.
That's boring.
Maybe the reason they chose civilian subjects is because they're planning to send those kinds of people to Mars in the future.
That sounds right. Strangers living together on Mars for an extended period of time. What kind of problems would that bring? How would the subjects figure out solutions to the resulting troublesome situations? According to the DCOM staff, that's what the experiment was trying to determine.
Like the chair-bound old man. They put us in a difficult position on purpose. To observe how we'd get out.
The sponsor is a civilian organization that hopes to expand business worldwide. Maybe they expect to be part of a colonization of Mars in the future.
Colonizing Mars?
You ever seen Prometheus? You send people who don't know what they're doing.
Have you ever heard this before? If you want to transport live koi from Brazil to Japan, putting only koi fish in an aquarium will result in most of them dying. But by adding something to that same container, you won't lose a single one.
What is it?
A piranha.
A piranha?
But how does that even work?
I guess their self-preservation instincts kick in.
I get it. Fish become so afraid of the piranha that they make an effort to live. That nervous state becomes the power to keep them alive.
Uh-huh. In order to survive, you need that sense of urgency.
I see. So, for an actual Mars mission, it'd be a good idea to have a murderer on the crew, huh?
Yep, that sounds like Prometheus.
Kidding!
Eric, don't say scary things like that.
Oh, so maybe all this stuff is something similar. Living quietly in DCOM becomes boring, so the emotional state will fade. If you intentionally inject a sense of emergency...
A little late, perhaps, but I will now announce the voting results. All three groups have voted for different teams. Therefore, none have been executed.
Okay, so this is the good route.
This is an ideal situation for any of us involved. It appears that none of you fully grasp the essence of this game. Think back on the rules you were told. You will remain in the shelter for eternity until six people are killed. I will give you one last chance. A single action from you may result in your escape from the depths. What must you do? It's simple. I shall show you.
Kill them all.
The other two teams are listening to a message just like this one. In their ward's decontamination room.
What?
The construction of all of them are the same. A yellow button exists on the wall in each. Pressing it activates the showers in the other wards, and they will rain down a solution of hydrogen fluoride.
No!
It's not only acidic enough to melt a body, but it even dissolves glass and iron.
Good, we didn't casually push it.
If you were under, it seems unnecessary. passes to escape. I have one final thing to tell you. The early bird gets the worm. After the first team pushes it, the button will become inactive for both of the other teams. Your time limit is 3 minutes. What will you do? Will you press it or refuse? It is ultimately all up to you to decide.
I feel like this is closer to Corpse Party than Danganronpa in some ways.
We gotta hurry or we'll die!
Don't worry. We need to trust the others.
The others, you say? What the hell do you know?
Hey! Stop! Where did the nice Eric go?
Shut the hell up, you fucking brat!
Why, Eric?
Ah!
Mira! At least he's quiet now.
What did you see in him?
I'll leave the rest of this up to you.
Huh?
It'll be interesting to see how you handle this.
What?
Like Corpse Party, there's a strong incentive to get the bad ends. A bit of a torture porn aspect to this. So, out of morbid curiosity, let me hit the button. Very morbid curiosity. I want to see if we get a ending.
What happened?
I see. Interesting.
Did you push the button?
Does this mean we're going to be saved?
But then... the others will...
You killed them! C-team and D-team are gonna...
No, we did. We had to do this so we could survive. There was no way around it.
But...
It's not my fault! I told you from the start not to push it!
I'm pretty sure you told us too.
What are you talking about? It was obvious you were planning on pressing it.
But you're the one who actually did! It was your hand. You pushed it!
You made a wise decision. You sacrificed the lives of others in order to continue your own survival.
Zero.
It truly is a natural human reaction. You simply made an emergency evacuation. The action is legally justifiable. There is no blame to be placed on you for your decision. Now, I'm sure you would like to get out of here immediately. But before that, I apologize. But you must all sleep again.
Why?
1929.
You have done exactly as I commanded. The memory loss drug will not be injected into the three of you.
I kind of like this team.
No! I didn't do it! He's the one who pushed it! So he's...
It would be... inconvenient if you forgot you caused the deaths of others.
But I already told you! I didn't kill anybody! I was only watching! Dad, I was just watching! No. Chris didn't do anything wrong. I was the one who... Please, forgive him, Dad. Cold. It's cold. The water was so... so cold.
Pleasant dreams.
Mom!
This team is so disorganized in a clusterfuck. It's very entertaining. That's what you want to see. People screw up in these situations. Oh, no, we're gonna see this from their perspective. Oh, God.
Where are we?
I think it's the decontamination room.
Decontamination?
I think we've been...
trapped in this room before.
Is it just deja vu?
Huh. I have a bad feeling about this.
So do I.
Wait, this button.
It's the same for you, Carlos?
You feel it as well?
Yeah, not just her. I sense it too. Somehow, this button is very important.
Maybe we lost our memories of it.
The drugs. In the bracelets.
Then, what in the world?
No, don't look at it. Oh God.
This is...
the lounge?
What happened in the decontamination room?
It would be inconvenient if you forgot to cause the deaths of others.
That's right. That button.
Now announcing the current casualties. C-Team. Carlos, Akane, Junpei. D-Team, Diana, Phi, Sigma. These six are now deceased. As a result, six X-Passes will be revealed. Dream, Key, Quark, Mom, Deer, Arm. That is all.
It's a lie! Everyone! Everyone!
Eric.
Oh no, what have I done?
No need to blame yourself. All you did was make the right choice.
You are very surprisingly cold.
But...
forget about it. We need to focus on what's next. We have six passwords. So can't we leave?
I overreacted a bit. But you know, maybe it's better this way. What I mean is, I know we're all in danger from this game. But instead of being forced to kill each other, it's just a vote and a press of a button.
Boy, you change your outlook fast.
Plus, we're just put to sleep after. So to suddenly learn the whole thing is over?
Wait, what if it's not just that? The amnesia drugs. In the bracelets. Maybe we didn't get injected this time. But what if every time we wake up, we have to go through the same scenario over and over again? And we're put to sleep after each one. Our memories of it, gone.
Give it up.
I'll break it for four.
We don't need to talk about this. Let's just get out of here.
He's right. Let's...
wait! Aren't we forgetting someone?
Can't forget the dog.
That's so mean.
Why in the...
Let's see if we can get it off.
Hey, about before, you were saying we're repeating our actions with no memories. It's like the Sleeping Beauty problem.
The Sleeping Beauty what?
It's one of the famous paradoxes. The experiment starts on a Sunday. The subject is put to sleep, and then a coin is flipped. If it's heads, the subject is woken up on Monday, asked a question, and put to sleep again. And that's it. That's all they do for heads.
And if it's tails?
They're woken up on Monday, asked a question, and put to sleep.
But that's just the same as heads.
To that point, it is. But it's different after that. After the subject falls asleep again, their memories from Monday are erased. They are then asked the same question again on Tuesday.
What's the question?
What was the probability it was heads?
That's it?
Yep, that's it.
Hey, how is that a problem then? It's obvious. There's a 50-50 chance of it being heads.
You'd think so, normally. But when you're being asked it, there are three positions you could be in. The coin was heads. It is Monday. The coin was tails. It is Monday. And the coin was tails. It is Tuesday. That would make the probability of it being heads as 1 in 3, right?
No.
No. I don't think so. It's a coin, so it'll always be 50-50 odds no matter what.
Okay, let's change some things. If heads appears, it's the same as before. But if it's tails, it ends up repeating 10,000 times.
10,000?
Wake, question, sleep, memory erased, wake, question, sleep, memory erased. Go through this 10,000 times. Does the probability still stay as 50-50 after all that?
Yes.
Thinking about it, wouldn't the chances of it being tails be higher than heads?
If you put it that way, yeah. So, which one is correct?
No one knows. They don't have an answer yet. Even the scientists can't decide between 1 in 2 and 1 in 3. It's an unsolved problem.
Huh. You know a lot about this.
I read a random book on it once. Well, it was on metempsychosis, but they deal with basically the same thing.
Metempsychosis? What is it?
Wouldn't waking up without your memories be just like being reborn?
Oh, yeah, that sounds similar.
I'm not really sure.
You don't believe in it?
I meant, there's no real meaning. Because when you're reborn, all the memories you had during your past life are already gone, right? That means metempsychosis isn't really needed.
If there's no memories, there's no point? Well, no one can perfectly remember things that happened when you were a kid. Hell, sometimes you can't even remember something from a month ago. So, going by what you said, everything you did before a month ago has no meaning?
She's asking if memories really are that important for making you who you are.
What is important then?
Well, something must be.
It's been taking them a long time to get that dog free, let me tell you.
Well, it looks like we can't do anymore.
We're gonna have to give up here.
I'm sorry. I'm really, really sorry.
No way around it. We did everything we could.
Come on, let's go.
Chain dog is just symbolism for our actions within the game. We leave it here to die and just shrug it off as we did everything we could.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
We show fake compassion by trying to free it. But really, we don't really try everything. Oh god, you want me to remember them. Okay, so it's Dream. Key. Quirk. Mom. Relatively straightforward passwords, in all honesty. Dear. Arm.
Yes! It opened!
Okay, let's go.
Hey, what's wrong?
What are you doing?
I can't go.
Huh?
I can't leave him behind. Sorry.
Most
I decided
thing.
That I'd stay here too. I wonder why. Maybe it's because I don't have memories? I know nothing about the outside world, so I guess I didn't really want to leave. Did I make the right choice? Or was it the wrong one? Yeah. That must be it.
I'm a dog. Bark. So let's try going through and not hitting the button.
Seems like the other teams didn't press it either.
I am so glad.
Are we safe?
Who really knows?
Mira? What? Watch where you're staring!
It seems there may be a misunderstanding, so I shall clear it up for you. I never said the showers would activate as soon as the button was pressed. Which means...
You sure you're not recording?
You've yet to learn whether the button has been activated by someone or not.
What? Then...
We'll have to wake up to find out if we're alive or not.
Now, it's time for you to sleep. When next you wake, know that you will have no memory of these past 90 minutes.
That's what they were teamed in with the bond did. So So this is similar to the Evermage choice, where every team has to select something. So we'll check out the C-Route people, see how they handle this whole situation.
This is called the decontamination room?
I think you're supposed to clean off after returning from the surface. Well, that was for when there was a nuclear war and the world was contaminated.
Ah, that explains the showerheads.
Just as I thought. This won't open either.
The map shows an elevator hall beyond this door. If we came down the elevator normally, we'd be able to run into this room immediately, but...
What about that? It's connected to the lounge.
I checked it earlier, but no dice. Locked up tight.
Do you think Zero trapped us in here to make us play the decision game?
It's pretty obvious at this point. 1810.
I think it was about 1330 when we finished voting and the drug put us to sleep.
So that means we were napping like toddlers for 4.5 hours.
Junpei, I have something I've been wanting to ask you. During the vote earlier, you told Carlos...
Come on, Carlos. Vote for Q-Team. Yeah.
Yeah, aren't you supposed to be a protag?
What about... How could you be so horrible? You used to... You'd never have said that a year ago.
Oh, like you're one to talk.
What? What? What happened to you, Junpei? What happened while I was gone?
I'd like to know more about you, too.
What's that, Carlos? Does that mean you're interested in me?
No. My focus is my little sister. Got no time for a love life.
Heh, so our hero of justice has a sister complex.
Junpei? Of course. Carlos really is worried about you.
Well, it's more I want to know about you both. Weren't you friends as kids? And last year you were trapped just like this. And escape together. So why?
Why the animosity, you mean? That's exactly why.
Junpei.
I've seen people die. Horrible, cruel deaths I never wanted to see. So many. I'm probably becoming numb. After what happened last year, I quit school and joined a detective firm.
Oh man. What made you want to do that?
It was all because of Akane there. She up and disappeared, so I went to a firm to try and find her. It's small, but known to work among the underground. I've snuck into places running human organ trafficking like they're trading cookies. Saw a coworker I'd just finished eating with pushed off a rooftop the other day. Never had a by-the-books case where I just had to prove he cheated. Every job that passed my hands was dirty and dangerous. That's when I realized. Humans aren't as beautiful as I thought. I'd only been skimming the surface all this time. So every day, after work, I'd drink myself to sleep. I slept in my bathtub with the shower running. It was the only way I was able to get the scent of blood off me. But last month, finally, I got intel through our network that Akane was joining this experiment.
So that's why you came to DCOM.
Yeah, I threatened those in charge and forced my way in.
Upbeat protag becomes an alcoholic and runs the most edgy detective agency ever.
So, Akane, how's Santa? Aoi.
My brother?
I heard about Ace. He's stuck in jail, if he hasn't escaped yet. Lotus is doing alright. She's working and raising her kids still.
Who told you this?
That detective guy, Seven. I worked with him once. We destroyed Free the Soul's headquarters.
Destroyed?
Hey, what's Free the Soul?
A religious cult. They're a freaky terrorist organization who never stop trying to create their new world.
They abducted my brother and I 10 years ago.
And the game we played last year was related to that big kidnapping case.
My brother and I were trying to track Free the Soul's movements, but you were too, Junpei?
I came across some info on them while I was working. Seven was the one still on their trail. But I kind of think we went too far by destroying their headquarters. I'm pretty sure we pissed off their boss. I think his name was Brother.
So wait, you're saying this Zero the Second has something to do with him?
You know anything about it, Akane?
I already told you, I'm not connected to this. I don't know why this person is calling themselves Zero.
Why don't you enlighten us as to why you joined DCOM, Akane?
Junpei.
Someone using that name has thrown us into a similar game. No way you can ask me to believe they're unrelated.
Stop it, Junpei. From what I can tell, Akane's the victim.
I'm here to change the future.
Huh?
Free the Soul is currently attempting to implement a terrifying plan. I infiltrated the experiment to stop that.
So you knew that this game would happen?
I don't know. I didn't know any specifics about all of this.
But you just said it's to change the future.
A very distant future.
So you accessed the morphogenetic field and...
Hold up. What are you talking about?
A little late, perhaps, but I will now announce the voting results.
Why'd he have to interrupt now?
Your monologue was getting boring.
What?
The construction of all of them are the same. A yellow button exists on the wall in each.
Oh, that thing.
Pressing it activates the showers in the other wards, and they will rain down a solution of hydrogen fluoride.
Hydrogen fluoride?
It's not only acidic enough to melt a body, but it even dissolves glass and iron. Explaining what would happen if you were under it seems unnecessary. Is your right to freedom. Using it will kill the other teams, and you will obtain the needed X passes to escape. I have one final thing to tell you. The early bird gets the worm. After the first team pushes it, the button will become inactive for both of the other teams. Your time limit is 3 minutes. What will you do? Will you press it, or refuse? It is ultimately all up to you to decide.
I'm going to have to get really used to hearing your voice
a lot. Isn't it obvious?
Junpei!
Wait! Let's think about this! Get out of my way, Akane! We need to push the button before the other teams do!
What are you saying, Junpei? Are you really planning to sacrifice everyone else so you can escape?
It's to survive!
That's his plan.
It's kill or be killed, so we need to make sure to kill them first!
Junpei! One here. You've changed so much.
Junpei!
Damn you! Do you want to die? You're okay with never seeing your sister again?
Maria.
No way in hell I'm dying! I did not go through everything just to die today!
If none of the teams push it, then it has to be like when we voted.
While you're wishing on a star, we'll end up killed.
Junpei!
Push it, Carlos!
Technically, one route you did end up killed. Sorry. I'm just gonna time it out for all the teams now.
It's been 3 minutes.
Does that mean none of the teams?
It has to mean no one pushed it!
Oh. That was the longest 180 seconds ever.
You're telling me. I'm nearly drowning in my own sweat. Like I practically had that acid bath already.
Run around, you did.
There may be a misunderstanding, so I shall clear it up for you. I never said the showers would activate as soon as the button was pressed. Which means, you've yet to learn whether the button has been activated by someone.
What?
No! Then when will we?
Less than a minute left before we're knocked out. That means...
So you're saying we won't even know until we're already melted into goo?
Now, it is time for you to sleep. When next you wake, know that you will have no memory of these past 90 minutes. Pleasant dreams.
So this is your version of this.
Would you stop talking nonsense?
Zero! You won't get away with this! I swear I'll...
May you rest in peace.
No, this is odd.
What's wrong? You okay?
We're alive.
Huh?
We really are alive, right?
Hey, are you sure you're all right?
There's a bruise on her neck, it looks like.
It was... a bad dream.
What happened?
Our necks... No. Never mind.
Well, dimension shifters.
Damn. Won't even budge.
Does that mean it's locked?
Yeah, seems that way.
So that means we're trapped, huh?
Where are we?
The decontamination room. That's how it's labeled on the map.
There are showers in here?
You need to wash all contaminants off after you return from outside. Well, in the case of nuclear war, of course.
Which means there are two exits heading to the surface. Here, and the X door in the lounge.
You're right. It looks like there's a hall to an elevator outside. I don't see how they're connected on the map, but it must be there.
Okay, then let's escape through that door.
How exactly do you propose that...
Looks like it's been welded shut.
Just push
Maybe
the button and everyone
it
dies.
Push that yellow button over there.
Did you not just hear that it's welded shut?
Then what exactly is it for?
Good times.
Should we try pushing it?
It's clearly suspect. Better not.
Right.
1809.
The anesthetic was injected after the vote, around...
1330.
So we've been asleep for almost 4.5 hours.
That might not be true.
Right. Zero did say.
Once 90 minutes are up, an injector in your bracelet will activate. An anesthetic and an agent to erase your memories will be administered.
means we could have woken up and fallen asleep several times since then. But we just don't remember any of it.
I wonder what the results of the voting are.
It's highly unlikely that C-Team was able to survive.
Why?
You even have to ask? Diana voted against the plan on the note and chose C-Team.
Whoa, wait, hold up. What are you saying? I thought Diana voted for Q-Team.
Man, everything's just screwed up on this route.
I'm sorry. I don't really remember.
What? How is that possible? How could you forget?
After the vote at 1330, he told us we wouldn't be injected with the amnesia meds.
Right. I remember it exactly. Diana had chosen to vote for Q-Team.
No!
I know for sure that she definitely voted for C-Team.
Nonsense. You must be out of it.
You're the one out of it, you senile old fart.
No. Wait. Don't tell me.
Jumped? What Sigma was going on about back in DCOM? Well, it's all true.
Oh, when he was saying mankind would be destroyed? What did he mean exactly? Do you mind explaining?
Even if I did, I don't think you'd believe me. It's highly likely you won't even understand. You see, the things Sigma and I have been through are, complicated and mysterious.
Does that mean your consciousness came from the future? 2074?
Yes, but that's not exactly right. Sigma and I both originated from the current world of 2028. Our consciousnesses were sparked by a specific event into jumping forward to 2074. We returned to April 2029, where we lived 45 years normally through time. In January 2074, our two consciousnesses were booted to the past again. And essentially ended up at this point in time, Christmas of 2028. See, you don't understand, do you?
It doesn't have to make sense. You only need to believe us.
About what happens in the future?
Correct.
I have to know then. Why was mankind destroyed?
It's not exactly destroyed. It isn't as if there aren't any survivors left.
But a large number are...
Yes, the dead number, 6 billion. It's all because of Radical 6. A horrific virus that affects the human brain. It spread quickly worldwide, and humanity began heading to extinction.
The location the virus originated at was the experimental facility, DCOM. That was what we were told, anyway. Some of the information appears to be incorrect, though.
How so?
This is just a guess, but I think Radical 6 wasn't leaked from DCOM. I've got a feeling it came from this shelter instead.
Regardless, back then we believed it all started at DCOM.
So that's why the entire world is at risk.
Subjects to prevent the release of the virus. With Akane's help.
Akane?
She's the leader of a secret group called Crash Keys that wants to save the world. Using the organization's assets, we hacked the admin server and altered the original subject list and data.
I see. I mean, it all seems so fake. I could hardly keep up with all of it.
We're not lying.
It's true.
All right, then. I'd like to go back for a second. Phi, you said you jumped earlier, right?
Yeah.
Does that mean...
So when consciousness is from a jump, dead timeline.
But I will now announce the voting results.
And everyone's from this timeline. Simple.
Different
I'm so glad.
I can't say this is an ideal situation for any of us involved. It appears that none of you fully grasp the essence of this game. Think back on the rules you were told. You will remain in the shelter for eternity until 6 people are killed. I will give you one last chance. A single action from you may result in your escape from the depths. What must you do? It's simple. I shall show you. The other two teams are listening to a message just like this one.
Yes, just like this one, like you've heard many times again.
That can't be.
The construction of all of them are the same.
Deja vu the game.
Exists on the wall in each. Pressing it activates the showers in the other wards, and they will rain down a solution of hydrogen fluoride.
What? Hydrofluoric acid?
It's not only acidic enough to melt a body, but it even dissolves glass and iron. Explaining what would happen if you were under it seems unnecessary. That button on the wall is your way to freedom. Using it will kill the other teams, and you will obtain the needed X-passes to escape. I have one final thing to tell you. The early bird gets the worm. After the first team pushes it, the button will become inactive for both of the other teams. Your time limit is 3 minutes. What will you do? Will you press it or refuse? It is ultimately all up to you to decide.
I feel like this team has a distinct advantage in that your consciousness don't seem to save the bodies.
Wait, don't!
I'm doing it to protect you two!
What?
It's not to escape. Of course I don't want to kill the other teams. But if we don't act, we're the ones who die.
It's not for certain. No one pushes it before 3 minutes are up.
But if we wait, all three teams will be killed. The acid will melt even our bones, and all that's left will wash down the drain. Is that how you want to reunite? To hug and cry together in the drain? By then, we wouldn't even be able to see or hold them.
Wait, Sigma! Please calm down!
How can I possibly do that? Someone on another team could be pushing the button right now as we speak.
Just listen, please! Zero did say that we had 3 minutes, but he never said what would happen once the time limit ended.
She's right. 3 minutes is just a space of time. There's still a chance nothing will happen after the deadline is over.
Especially since that'd be too boring for the criminal.
It must mean that we're being tested to see how much we all trust.
Please believe, Sigma. Trust the other teams.
I'll let this one run out, so that way we get to what I believe is probably the good end route. And I'll go back for the endings afterwards.
Nothing's happening.
Yeah.
See? I told you, didn't I? None of the others pushed the button. So that's proof that the other teams can be trusted to cooperate.
Except Q-Team, those bastards.
It seems there may be a misunderstanding, so I shall clear it up for you. I never said the showers would activate as soon as the button was pressed. Which means, you've yet to learn whether the button has been activated by someone or not.
What?
And when?
Then the anesthetic will...
I get it now.
Don't tell me we'll be asleep when...
Now, it's time for you to sleep. When next you wake, know that you will have no memory of these past 9 minutes. Pleasant.
I feel like inherently the separate route's probably more interesting.
Oh.
The choice is made.
Carlos, why?
No, Akane.
Hey, you did good, Carlos.
Junpei?
You dedicated your life to saving people, so this is probably hard for you. But what you did is...
Stop!
Carlos!
It wasn't me! Someone took my hand and...
You're not going to say the devil made you do it, are you?
Made
We're
me?
The criminal.
Maybe it's stress, or you've always had that urge buried deep down inside.
Blamed your bad judgment calls on something controlling you?
We were the ones manipulating and watching
it's
everything.
It's just part of being human. Life experiences.
You made a wise decision. You sacrificed the lives of others in order to continue your own survival.
Zero.
It truly is a natural human reaction. You simply made an emergency evacuation. The action is legally justifiable. There is no blame to be placed on you for your decision. Now, I'm sure you would like to get out of here immediately. But before that, I apologize. But you must all sleep again.
But why?
It is 1929. Time for good kids to be in bed, or something.
You have done exactly as I commanded. The memory loss drug will not be injected into the three of you. It would be inconvenient if you forgot you caused the deaths of others.
I killed all of them.
Pleasant dreams.
So let's see your bad ending. It's gonna be kind of rough seeing everyone die again. Oh, they saved the dog though, going with the preview.
This is...
the decontamination room.
Decontamination? Huh. This is weird.
Weird?
I feel like I've been trapped in this room before.
You must be imagining things.
I guess. This button.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Yeah, something isn't right.
Maybe we've forgotten about this place.
The drugs and the bracelets?
What?
Still haven't deciphered those texts. The camera does pan to it on all these endings, which concerns me.
Now announcing the current casualties. Q-Team, Q, Mira, Eric. D-Team, Diana, Phi, Sigma. These six are now deceased. As a result, six X-Passes will be revealed. Self, Rip, Lake, Bird, Twin, Old. That is all.
That's right. I...
It would be inconvenient if you forgot to cause the deaths of others.
I wonder if you can do something like remembering the passwords and using them later.
Wow, that was fast. We put these passwords in, and we can reach the surface.
But to get them, the other teams...
It's not your fault, Carlos.
I've been busting my ass for the past 10 years. I wanted to save as many lives as I could. I worked hard to do that.
Leucochloridium. Or Spinocordodes telaneae. Have you heard of either of these, Carlos?
Why are you suddenly...
They inhabit and control the actions of creatures larger than them. Parasites.
Are you like suggesting video game players. We were controlled by whatever that was you said?
Leucochloridium are snail parasites. Praying mantises and grasshoppers get Spinocordodes telaneae.
So they don't attach to humans?
Correct. I've heard of one, however. Toxoplasma gondii.
Toxoplasma gondii?
Rats with toxoplasmosis no longer fear their predator, the cat, and are in fact drawn to the smell of their urine.
The rats are attracted to cats?
For humans infected with Toxoplasma gondii, changes in actions and personality have been reported. You become a risk taker, your reactions slow, or you become extremely sensitive.
Are you saying Carlos pushed that button because of something like that?
I don't know. But it's more realistic than saying you were possessed by a devil.
A human controlling parasite.
Huh. Like someone who eats Cheetos and sits in a chair. I don't eat Cheetos, but you know, the stereotype. I find it funny how the game does try to explain some of these things. That would seem out of character for some of these
characters,
obviously.
Are you guys ready?
Obviously.
Yes.
No problems here.
Alright. Then let's put in the passwords.
It opened! It opened!
Let's hurry! The door will close right away!
Hey, what are you standing around for?
Carlos?
I can't leave with you guys.
What?
Huh?
I made a promise in another history that I'd definitely save you two.
Another history?
What nonsense are you babbling about? Come on, hurry up!
Later, guys.
Carlos!
Carlos!
Indirectly killed by the promise he made in another route.
Just hang on. I'm going to go save you now.
He just walks through the wall.
What?
Wait.
So while we do have some leapers, per se, not quite true leaping in the team, it seems like the leaders of every team have a lot stronger acknowledgement of the different routes than everyone else.
Diana, what did you just...
Are you kidding me? You just finished begging me to trust the others! What the hell was all that for? Answer me, Diana!
I don't know. I don't know why I pushed the button.
Not again.
What do you mean?
Our vote back at 1330? Diana chose C-Team instead of going along with what was on the note. I asked her why, and she said the same thing as now. I don't know.
That's ridiculous. I don't know about that.
I know.
What?
I'm saying I know what you don't know. My thought earlier, that we probably...
You made a wise decision. You sacrificed the lives of others in order to continue your own survival.
Perhaps canonically, we're actually supposed to get these endings, because we do need the passwords after all.
You simply made an emergency evacuation. The action is legally justifiable.
So the characters in this time don't realize it. But there is a reason for them to be here. Or is this an indirect explanation for a fourth wall break?
But you must all sleep again.
1929. Our time is up.
You have done exactly as I commanded. The memory loss drug will not be injected into the three of you. It would be inconvenient if you forgot you caused the deaths of others.
No! How did this happen?
Pleasant dreams.
Let's check out their abandon.
Where are we?
I think it's the decontamination room.
Decontamination?
Huh. This is weird.
Weird?
I feel like I've been trapped in this room before.
You must be imagining things.
I guess.
Wait, this button.
It's the same for you, Carlos?
You feel it as well?
Yeah, not just her. I sense it too. Somehow, this button is very important.
Maybe we've forgotten about this place.
The drugs and the bracelets?
What?
Don't blame yourself, it was me.
Look what time it is. It's after midnight.
So, it's the next day?
Not just day, but year. It's 2029 now.
What a horrible start to the year.
Now announcing the current casualties. C-Team, Carlos, Akane, Junpei. Q-Team, Q, Mira, Eric. These six are now deceased. As a result, six X-Passes will be revealed. Shift, six, ring, age, heart, love. That is all.
Damn you, Zero!
I will never forgive him!
At least this team actually didn't just mope about it.
No!
Except for Diana.
Diana, tell me one more time. You didn't choose to push it, did you? The button in the decontamination room.
No. For a split second, it was as if... It was as if someone had taken control of my body.
Has this ever happened to you before? Then maybe you hit your head somewhere.
I don't think so. That I can remember, anyway.
What are you trying to say, Fi?
Well, I thought it might be possible it was alien hand syndrome.
Both of you came up with some different explanations for this.
It happens very rarely when the corpus callosum, where the right and left hemispheres connect, is abnormal. Remember, the right brain controls the left side, and the left controls the right. So if the communication paths that connect them are damaged, the left and right sides of your body may fall out of sync. Like trying to put a shirt on with your right hand, but taking it off with your left. Grabbing onto a scalding pan with your right hand while your left tries to make it let go. Or something even stranger, when your right hand attempts to suffocate you, so you use your left to restrain it. I've heard of cases where it's happened. An interesting development arises with that story. Where does a human's consciousness exist? Is it in the left brain or the right? When your right hand's choking you, and your left's trying to stop it. That would imply that the part of you that doesn't want to die is in the right brain. But what if, in the left brain, there's another part of you buried inside that does want to die? So, if you ever ask that person, do you want to live or die? If the center for speech is located in the right brain, he'd clearly say, of course, I want to live. But what if it's the reverse? If the center for speech is in the left brain, then I'm sure he'd say, hurry up and kill me. There's no way to know which one is the true self. Or, perhaps, it's more like they both are. It's just simply that the one who has the power of speech is more dominant. Have you ever considered, what if your body was split into left and right? In that moment, where would your consciousness go? Left or right?
Hey, Fi. What are you getting at with this?
The alien mouth syndrome. My mouth speaks for itself, regardless of what I want it to do.
How can you be joking around at a time like this?
No, it's because we're in the situation that I brought it up.
Well, like you said, it doesn't feel real. Hearing the announcement or reading on the board.
You think those six might still be alive?
Let's keep believing.
There's no point. The six of them are definitely dead.
How do you know?
Well, I don't know.
You've seen it before in another route.
You all right, Gab?
This guy doesn't know anything, does he?
He's lucky.
Well, we may as well get
going. Dog's a killer.
Like Sigma said earlier, we shouldn't lose hope. Let's have faith that they're still alive. Besides, that is even more of a reason that we must keep going.
So we can go and bring back a rescue team?
Exactly.
So shift 6, ring age, heart, catch it, love being.
All right, let's go.
Oh, everyone left in this group. This is new.
I'm not going.
Huh?
Hey, Diana!
So all the leaders are compelled to stay. Also, seems the leaders are perspective in this storyline, too, interestingly enough. Maybe the leaders have to stay for the experiment to go on, so this loop keeps going.
Wonderful acting. It's an excellent strategy. Your actions in the decontamination room. I'm surprised you thought of it so fast. At that moment, all you wanted was to get out quickly. To make that a reality, it just happened that the fastest way was to touch a yellow button and kill the other 6 participants. However, pressing the button just like that would make you a murderer, a bad person. And even if you did escape after, in a court of law, what you did would be considered bad by judge and jury. So you thought, how could I make this not as bad for me? What you came up with was, oh, so simple. You simply needed multiple personalities.
No!
But to casually bring up the topic of multiple personalities, no one would believe you. The only way
you sure you're not recording
believable was to do something unbeneficial to you. And that is why you refused to leave. We both know that Fire will bring a rescue team back to the shelter. You saw all of that in advance.
No!
Let us meet again somewhere. Stop at Mata Dolorosa. I will be awaiting that moment.